praise the Lord. As we read the 24th chapter of Matthew, we see the prophecies that Jesus gave about the end times. And we see most of those happening right in front of our eyes. Nations rising against nation, kingdom against kingdom, famines, fires, earthquakes, pestilences, viruses. All these things are happening as we watch. But there is a sign that Jesus spoke about, which we hardly speak about, and that is given in the 10th verse of Matthew chapter 24. And I'm going to read it from the NKJV version. Matthew 24, verse 10. And then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another. If you look around our nation, in our society, in our politics, in our media, in our families, there is so much hatred that is going around. People are getting offended for any and every silly reason. Whether there is reason or not, people are getting easily offended. Why do we get offended? The dictionary says the meaning of getting offended means to get upset, get annoyed, or get resentful. Do you get easily upset? Do you get annoyed at someone? Are you resentful of something that was done to you or done by someone? This message is for you. Why do we get offended? I'm going to give you 7 reasons, and let's see how we can stop being offended. Number one, we get offended when things do not go our way. Remember Judas? He probably was looking for a Messiah who was going to set up an earthly kingdom. He was getting rich, robbing the money from the money bag. And here was Jesus talking about going to the cross. Judas's income was probably going to stop. And he got offended. And the result of that offense was anger. When you get offended, you get angry. And you do things that you should not. And Judas does the same. He betrays Jesus. Look at Peter. A few days before Jesus' crucifixion, Jesus is talking to his disciples and telling them that how he is going to die. And Peter gets offended. Because here is Jesus going around doing good, healing the sick, preaching the gospel, raising the dead. And Peter is one of the important leaders within Jesus' circle. And Jesus is saying he's going to die. And Peter probably gets offended. And he tries to stop Jesus from going to the cross. And Jesus turns to him and says, "Get behind me, Satan." We don't know why Peter denied Jesus. Maybe, just maybe, Peter got offended because of this rebuke and then denied Jesus. When things do not go our way, we get upset, we get annoyed, we get resentful, and it results in anger building up within us. Why do we get offended? Number two, when we are not recognized enough, we get offended. Moses got offended when the people began to complain and grumble and murmur. The same Moses who brought them out of Egypt with the mighty hand of God, who parted the Red Sea, who gave them water from the rock. Now, a second time, people are still complaining. They are forgetting what an awesome and charismatic leader they have. And Moses gets angry. And he hits the rock, disobeying God and dishonoring God. Disciples that Jesus sent to evangelize come back to him. and they are upset and angry when people do not listen to their message. You know, their pride is hurt. Because despite having the power of God, some are rejecting the gospel. And the disciples want to call down fire from heaven. Can you imagine? The purpose Jesus sent them was to save men. And here are they wanting to destroy those men who have rejected the gospel. We get offended when our pride, when our ego is hurt. The third reason why we get offended is when someone else in the similar condition does better than us. Remember Cain? Cain and Abel were in the similar situation. They were in the same environment. But Abel's offering is accepted by God and Cain's is rejected. And Cain gets angry. He gets jealous with his brother's success and it results in murder. Remember, getting offended is not just a single sin. It results in some other sin. When you get offended, you do not remain just offended. You can turn into a murderer. The fourth reason, why do you get offended? You get offended when someone does not get the punishment that he deserves. David speaks about this dilemma in Psalms and he says, when I looked at the wicked and that they were prospering, they were getting richer, they were healthier. He says, he was offended. But in the end, he understood. Many a times we do not understand when the wicked prosper and the righteous suffer. And when the wicked does not get punished as they deserve, many a times we get offended. You may be going through suffering. You may be going through poverty. You may be going through difficulty. And you see someone who deserves to be punished, who is prospering, who is having good health, who is succeeding in everything that they do. You may get offended with God and say, there is no use serving God. Remember, when you get offended, you are filled with hatred. Remember the prodigal son's brother? Even as the prodigal son comes back, the father is welcoming the son and the elder brother is hoping, is expecting the father to punish him. And when that punishment does not come through, the elder brother is easily offended. He even does not want to go inside the house. You know, hatred within you may cause you not to enter into the blessings of God. You may prefer to stay outside rather than forgive and allow someone, you know, the grace of God in their lives. Why do we get offended? Reason number five is when someone else also gets the grace that we got. Because many times we feel it's okay, we are blessed. God loves me, God cares for me, and His grace is available to me. But when God gives the same grace to someone else, we get offended. The new church, the believers in the new church, the Jewish believers got offended when God showed His grace even to the Gentiles. They could not understand it. You know, it's okay, it's good to be blessed by God, to receive His grace and mercy. But we should be careful that we do not stand in the way of God and His blessings from reaching another. God is gracious to all. Bible says He wants to save all mankind. He does not want anyone else to perish. And we must remember that if we are born again, if we are believers, if we are going to heaven, if our names are written in the book of life, if we are healed, if we are blessed, it is only because of the grace of God. And that grace is available to all. And we should not feel let down. We should not feel upset. We should not feel angry when someone else gets the same blessings and the same grace. Number six, we get offended when we realize God has a bigger heart. You know, God is more gracious, more wonderful, more loving than we can ever imagine or understand. Jonah had this problem. When God sent him to Nineveh with a message of repentance, of course, Jonah in the end preached the message, but he expected his message to come true, that God's wrath to come upon Nineveh. But when God relented and forgave Nineveh because they turned and repented, Jonah's pride was hurt. He could not understand how God could be so loving, so merciful, because he did not know how big God's heart was. When we cannot understand how great God's goodness and his mercy and his kindness is, we too may stand in the way of God, and we may get offended because God is so good. And finally, we get offended when things do not go the way we think they should go. Probably you would like this service to happen offline, and you may get offended that this is online. Or if this goes offline, you may want this service to be online, and you may get offended with your leaders. You may get offended if someone's testimony goes too long. We sometimes get offended when someone gets leadership role when we think they do not deserve it. We get offended sometimes if the AC is too cold or if the weather is too hot. We get offended when someone doesn't recognize us or smile at us. There may be 100 reasons we get offended, and offense is a common sin. But we must remember once again, offense doesn't remain a unique sin, a single sin. It gives birth to many other sins like anger, hatred, pride, being judgmental, and selfish and self-centered. Can you imagine if God also got offended every time you and I sinned? You know, that's the beauty of grace, that God does not get offended with us. Every time we fall, every time we miss the mark, every time we are weak, God shows grace and more grace. He shows mercy and new mercies. He gives life and life in abundance. And as his children, God wants us to be the same. He wants us to display his character, his nature, and that is being gracious, merciful, and compassionate to our brothers and to our sisters. When we get offended, we are telling God that we are not okay with God being in charge. We are telling God that, God, we do not like the way you behave with other people in other situations. We want it to be done like this. We want you to deal with those people in this manner. We want that person to be punished. We don't want this person to be blessed. We want this thing to run according to my will. What we are saying is, God, I don't like you being in charge. In fact, I would like to be in charge. When you get easily offended, you say, God, I am upset because my will is not being fulfilled. I would like to be in control, but it looks like you are in control. Many a times, when we get offended, we believers have a beautiful way of expressing it. We say that it is righteous anger. We say we are displaying righteous anger when we are offended. But be careful that when you are displaying your righteous anger, you are not coming in the way of God showing His grace to someone else. That you are getting upset because God is being merciful, God is being gracious, God is being kind, God is being loving to someone else. Most of the time, with us believers, that is the case, that we are getting upset and angry because God is being who He is, gracious. If God was not gracious to us, merciful to us, compassionate to us, you know, there were so many people, there was powers of darkness which wanted us to be destroyed. And if God had punished us according to our sins, our weaknesses, where would we be today? But God showed us mercy. God showed us compassion. God showed us love. And today, as His children, God wants us to do the same thing. And we should be careful that we do not get easily offended. I will read you one more verse from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 17, verse 1. Gospel of Luke, chapter 17, verse 1. Then Jesus said to His disciples, "It is impossible that no offenses should come, but woe to him through whom they do come." Jesus is saying, offenses will come. People will get upset. People will get annoyed. People will get resentful. But Jesus says, woe to him. Cursed is he through whom it comes. Let our desire be, let our prayer be this today. That God, I don't want offense to come through me. Number one, I don't want to get offended myself. When things don't go my way, when things don't happen as I want them to be happening, when others succeed, when others prosper, when you bless others, when you lift up somebody else, help me not to get offended. Help me not to get upset. Help me not to get angry. Help me not to get resentful. And secondly, help me not to allow someone else to get offended with me. Even as believers, we should be careful that we do not cause someone else to get offended with us. The Bible speaks about eating non-veg food. You know, we are free to do that. We are free to wear whatever we want to wear. We are free to live as we want, under the freedom that God has given to us according to His word. But sometimes our freedom may cause someone else to sin, someone else to get offended. And we should be careful, you know, that we do not cause offense to anyone, neither do we get ourselves offended. Being offended is one of the end times signs. So dear children of God, people of God, are you getting offended? It's easy to talk about wars, pestilences, viruses, wars, earthquakes, and fires. But this little enemy in your own backyard, in your own life, that is causing you to be unfruitful, that is causing you to be ineffective, that is causing you to be a bad witness in the kingdom of God, is your own offense. Do you get easily offended, upset, angry, resentful when things don't happen as you want them to? Do not. That is one of the end time signs. Be restful in the Lord Jesus Christ. Be compassionate. Be willing to accommodate others. And you will enjoy the favor of God, the pleasure of God, because then you have the heart that is exactly like the heart of God. And that's God's will for you. That's God's plan for you. That's God's desire for you. God bless you.